You want them ready to go when you need them, but there's a lot of training that goes into flying and maintaining fighter jets.
But we wanted to get the highest quality training we could for them.
Once a year, the 334 Fighter Squadron will leave their home base in North Carolina and test their skills in a new environment.
It's a good training environment for them, so they can prepare to do it in any type of combat situation.
Dealing with different procedures to get in and out of the airspace and working in unfamiliar territory helps them develop what they call airmanship.
The ability to deal with challenges and dynamic situations in the airplane in real time.
Before taking off, the jets are looked over by maintainers who offer on-the-spot fixes to make sure the jets are in top shape for their mission. They fly training missions twice a day, focusing on surface attacks, which teaches them how to strike their targets from above. New Hampshire was selected for temporary duty because it offered a training opportunity they can't get at their home base.
The mountainous low flying is something that we can't get in eastern North Carolina, and it was just an opportunity to push the limits of what they're comfortable with.
While the 334 Fighter Squad is working on and flying the F-15s they're used to, they learn how to work in tandem with other squadrons too. Pease is using its KC-46A refueler in the missions, and the Green Mountain boys out of Vermont are meeting up with their F-35s.
So they can get training from us, we can get training from them.
They'll be here for the next week. They leave on June 16th. At Pease Air National Guard Base, Kelly O'Brien, WMUR News 9.